Okay, so underneath me right now there is ice. Ice still works through half blocks. So when I walk, I'm hitting the ice. Okay, well that's whatever. Just whatever. Don't even care. Not even fast. I couldn't give a frickin' damn. Do do do. 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 Do do. Right. And then we'll go kind of give it its overhang. No, which I think should probably not go on all sides. Okay, let me add in another two uprights here, remove this bit and bring these two out. And this will be the kind of protruding bit into the next level. Itch my ear a second. So that means if we have the second level going up like 1, 2, 1, 2 and then going up. So it's going to be a very wide roof, but it could look quite nice. And then this bit will go up into it, and it should end up level. And it has, yep. So that's 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. La la la. Okay. I just became aware that my microphone might actually be turned off because I didn't check. I always forget to check. Anyway, yeah, so about the new PC. It's i7 processor, quad core. I can't really remember all the specs about it. 8 GB of RAM, which could be more, but it's upgradable to 16 GB, so I can add on RAM as and when I feel like I need it, but I should have the money for it. I've kind of overextended myself in terms of how much money I have, but it just means that I'm pretty screwed when it comes to car buying. And that's part of the reason why the donations would really help, because then I can think about like the server and stuff without having to weigh it up with my own costs. You know, if I could kind of keep YouTube costs and my like personal costs in a kind of separate state, that'd be really great, because then I basically know how much I have and how much I can spend on the server, how much I can spend on maybe paying people to run the server and stuff like that. Which would be really great, because I don't really fancy running a server, to be honest. It's kind of what stopped me from doing so far. Now, it has to be normal wood for these bits here. Now, so this will be, have a nice window in it. Oops. There we go. Oh, and a little bit about the next build. I know it's a little bit early to be speaking about that, but it's going to be in a swamp, and it's going to be really cool. It's going to be medieval Tudor style. If you are familiar, in a recent video I asked, you know, what was the favourite thing you've ever seen me build, and quite a lot of people said, a lot of people said desert, and I will definitely be redoing the desert build in the future. I'll probably be the one after the swamp. But a lot of people also said that the first thing I ever did, which was actually the kind of thing that started off the channel, it was the first build I ever did, it was a Tudor medieval city type thing. It had a castle, it had a port, it was the full deal. You know, I spent a huge amount of time on it. Didn't build anything on camera, of course, at that time. Didn't have Let's Builds back in the day. But I did a few videos, you know, just kind of showing it off and stuff, and I uploaded one of them to minecraft.net, which is where I got like 500 subscribers. Do I give it all the overhang? No. So yeah, I'll be doing the kind of similar style to that. Try and keep the building size small. I feel like in this build, the building size has been big, and that's great, and it's a breath of fresh air, especially for my channel. You guys know what I'm like with small buildings, but I much prefer building small, and I will be doing so. But the most important thing is, if you're making something, let me just work this out. Yeah, if you're building something deliberately small, then you need to really think interior focused, and that is what I really enjoy doing. That's like my kind of fun thing. I don't mind doing these big houses at all. Like, it gives you so much scope, it gives you some real freedom. But nothing is quite like building a tiny little house. Which is kind of sad, but that's my OCD thing. That's why I play Minecraft. I enjoy trying to I almost said trying to fit small things in places. Or fit things in small places. Oh, I suppose I have said it now, haven't I? Oh dear. Dirty mind working in overdrive this evening. As I said, it's pretty late. Right. Oop. Who's there? Got a hole here. Screw it. That's what I did over there. Seemed to work. And that comes up to there, but that needs to go horizontal. Right. That's looking quite nice, hopefully. And we'll add on our little decorative pieces here and see how that goes. Sniff. Oh my god, it suddenly got really bugged up all of a sudden. My cold's all but gone now, which is nice. I'm also feeling a lot better. Oh god, where am I going to put this? Right, let's see how that looks, because that was weird. Oh no, it's weird. Oh god. Okay, I'm going to have to resize that, which means that we do have this bit of wood here, which is not nice. Okay, that's how I'll deal with it. Upright. Two across. Two down. Remove that. Place that. Hiccup. Oh, no, I need that one. I need that one. I need to do that one and that one. Yeah, right, and then we need to do these bits. Come on brain, keep working, you've been doing well so far. For some reason I've done so many of these roofs but I still have to concentrate so hard every time. Oh dear. Oh, my laptop's making weird noises at me. Ba-doop. Yeah, so this computer's going to take ages to get here. It's like a 16-day thing, because obviously they're building it for you, as well as sending it, and I didn't want to pay... Yeah, you could pay 50 quid to have it within 5 days. Do I really need it in 5 days? Not really. I just kind of want it in 5 days. Normally I'm a sucker for buying, like, express delivery. No, stop snowing, please, thank you. Oh no. There we go. Did you just see that weird red glitchy thing then? I hope that's there actually on the video, otherwise I'm going to seem mad right now. I just saw some red glitching. Might have been an Enderman, like, dying from water. Well, okay, that ice is spreading, that's a bit annoying. Oh. Ooh, got a nice tall window. No, that's way too tall. That's looking quite gothic, actually. It's quite cool, in a way, sort of. Right, let's do this interior quick then. I won't spend too long on it, because I do want to build that ship. So, that needs to be... that. Nice, right, so let's put some windows in there. Window there, window there. grab some glass panes. Now, this really shouldn't be so open, so I think this should be basically like a grill where people come and speak to the person. And then we'll have more windows. So two block wide there, two block wide there, two block high there, and two block high there. That should be enough, really. Now we'll do the beams. There we go. And the ceiling, which I'm not going to spend a particularly long time on, I'm just going to cover it in wood. Fail. There we go. Right, and then downstairs we can have fancy little beamy things in the middle. I like that, and that's the way it is. I don't want this house to look particularly like fancy. I want it to look like it's my nose. I want it to look like basically someone's paid to come and do this job, and they didn't necessarily enjoy it very much, but. Yeah, they get this house, which isn't particularly nice, but they make do with what they got. Door. Haven't done the floor yet, have I? Let me do the floor. That probably makes sense. And I will do that like that, and then like that. Four. Four. Five. Yeah, maybe have this bit separated. You will see why in a second. Great. Right, so this is kind of like the business end. So a guy obviously needs a desk to do all his work at, and he can have a nice cobblestone. No, not cobblestone. Okay, maybe wood then. I'll just do the whole thing out of wood. And then he can have a chair, so this is where he sits and does his dirty work out the window. That sounds disgusting. Blech. And then he's got all of his like logs and everything all over here, kind of stacked around. I've got connected textures on. I forgot I had that on actually. Oh well, it's not really a bad thing. Yeah, so he's got all his like logs and everything over here, and also a chair so that he can read them. That's a stupid idea. No. I guess that really shouldn't be like that. Give it. Has to be symmetrical. It'll bug the hell out of me. You can have another bookcase there just to save some space. There you go. So this is kind of like the business end, and then in here is the living end. So part of the living end involves having, you know, like an upstairs. So we shall give him a ladder up, and this is going to be where he does like his crafting and stuff like that. So this is the utility end of the living end. So let's give him a furnace too. Furnace. There we go. And I will go for a simple kind of configuration here. Furnace. No, we'll just see if that has it. Here we go. So this is where he does all his crafting. He's got a table which he should really be made out of fence. I don't think I'm going to have time to do the ship this episode. And that's fine, because I've got a video on a ship already, and I'm pretty happy with that ship. So if you do want to see a Viking ship, check that video out. I think type in Jamziboy Minecraft Viking ship tutorial. Should work. Let's see, why not. Oh no, that won't work. Okay. Right, I'll go on the inside here, then oh balls, oh, that's a real oops. You're causing problems, room. Trying to make you look pretty, but you're not helping. That could work. Where's my bookshelf gone? There is. Stack up bookshelves in these little gaps here. Make the room seem a bit more cosy. Obviously that one's for the ladder, so we don't want one there. And let me itch my foot a second. Ah, that's so itchy. Oh my god. Give it some pretty looking beams. Can't put one there. Put them there, there. Yeah. Right, and then we'll have a bedroom, which can be, I suppose we should really have this beam going up here, and that way we can separate off half of the room. And then this half of the room will be open. No, I don't know. If I bring in beams from here, by beams I mean wood. Okay, so then here's the bedroom, and the entrance can be here. I suppose it should be opposite the ladder. There we go. And then in here we can have a nice double bed. Maybe a single bed. Maybe a triple bed. Have a double bed with a locker. And we can also give him a chair to sit and read his lovely book on. You know, Nord's got to read his books, you know. True story. Light. And then through here we can have a desk up against this wall. Because, contrary to popular belief, you can never, never have too many desks. It's true. Never. It's impossible. There we go. And fill it back in. There we go. Right, so let's just bring it back downstairs, pop some more lights up, and then I will end this episode. Great. So there you go. There's the kind of shipmaster's office. Now, I am actually pretty happy with this build, so I'm going to say, if you want a tutorial, let me know below, and I might do a tutorial on this. But it was pretty straightforward, so you know, if you can do it from this video, then that'd be great, because I would like to move on. But if you do want a tutorial, I will be happy to, because I'm pretty happy with how this turned out. I like that kind of window thing. Yeah, so I think I've got a few things to say before I go. This is the end of this build, obviously, so let me know what you think you've thought of this build. Let me know if the way that I've kind of been doing the series, let me know if you like that. Let me know what anything you think I'd change about it and stuff like that. Don't forget to rate and all that sort of stuff in Majiggy. Yeah, read this little section about donation again if you didn't catch what I said about it earlier. That'd be really awesome. And that's it, is it? I could have sworn there was one more thing I had to say. There must have been one more thing. Well, bugger it. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you guys in the swamp. Yay!